All right, let's talk about keto and veggies and why you should use veggies and how do you use them. Just subscribe below if you want all the updates when we upload the newest videos on keto health, wellness, vitality. Check it out. Come join us. All right, you ready to get this thing on? Okay, let's do this. Okay, so I'm going to talk about the mashup, the power of ketones, the power of veggies, how do you strategically use veggies and stay keto and stay healthy, but also improve your health in a big way. So we got to talk a little bit about how I figured this all out. It wasn't me, by the way, somebody way smarter than I am. And so I got this from the doctor. His name is Dr. Tatis Karazian, super smart dude. And basically he said, dude, you need to do the mashup. I'm like, what's the mashup? He goes, we need to get diversity in your gut lining. I'm like, okay, I knew that gut health was important. I knew that, you know, probiotics, I've been using probiotics for years. That's a great thing, right? He goes, yeah, but he goes, are your stools clean? He's like, are you pooping clean? Yes, I'm talking about poop. He goes, are you pooping clean? I'm like, not always. I go, sometimes my stool get loose. Sometimes they get relaxed. Sometimes I'm flushing. I'm like, he's like, so that tells me you're one of the big reasons. Either you're eating too much fat too fast and your body can't digest it very well. But there's a good chance because of your health history and your background that your gut flora isn't dialed in right and you don't have diversity in your gut. And so what does that mean? So when you eat fibrous foods and low carb ones, stay keto, what happens is that it creates soluble fibers can be broken down and consumed by the gut and actually produce probiotics, which is the good bacteria that you want in your body and a really good bacteria and your positive bacteria for your health. This will lead towards a better immune system, better vitality, better fat loss. This will lead to bulkier stools. So it's a clean wipe. Like literally you poop and you don't have to wipe yourself. How cool is that, right? That's what this leads to. So the key is that how do you get this in there still staying keto at the same time? Well, the good thing is everything I have here is relatively keto friendly or low carb. There's a couple things that are, you know, you could probably question if you're a purist, carrots, right? But the amount that you're gonna have are so low that it shouldn't matter for most of you. Let me show you this. So we have strawberries in our house. So strawberry tops. Cut them off, save them, and we'll use them in the shake that I'm gonna show you a little bit later. So anyway, I have about 14 different vegetables here. Some of them are already made and washed, and then I just throw them in a bag. Some of them I have to chop up, parsley, I'm chopping up, cilantro, bok choy, carrots. And then you keep the carrot top. You use this. The carrot top is actually the part that I want the most. I don't peel the carrots. I just scrub them really good, and I chop them all up, throw them in a bag. So just really cool kale. I got, my favorite is cabbage. I just eat cabbage. I love cabbage. I'm kind of a cabbage nut. And there's so many other vegetables you can put out here. You can just literally print out the list of low carb vegetables and chop them up and do this. It's really, really cool. Maybe I'll put a list down below of some veggies that you can get. And you can literally, Brussels sprouts. You can just order it off there. Raw asparagus, other things that you can do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wash it. I'm going to chop them into little small pieces. And then I'm gonna throw them into these bags. I put four different vegetables in each bag. And now you don't have to buy a lot. Like this will last for quite a while. And then twice a day, at least once a day, morning or like late morning, maybe to break your fast, or in the afternoon, if you really wanna stay fasted, do it in the afternoon and early evening. And you do is you take like a little blender, a bowl it, and I just take a couple of little handfuls, toss it in there. Throw some water if you want it to taste kind of just plain water. I will do almond milk. I do coconut milk. I don't do a lot of almonds, so I do mostly coconut milk if I do anything. I'll do ketones on there. I may even make a little bit of protein. I'll do a nice clean low carb protein and I'll make it into almost like a mini smoothie. Now I'm used to the tasting of it all. It's not a big deal for me, but, and then you drink it down. Just keep this in mind. It takes time to create that flora. So look at a week to 2 weeks and watch how your stools shift you'll actually have a sense of fullness if you're a person that gets hungry a lot and you don't know why. This is another reason this can help. And then watch what happens to your belly will start to flatten more. It's really, really cool. But do keep in mind, if you drink too much at one time, your body because your body will consume it, it can actually get a little heavy. So start with a small amount and work up. And I recommend rotating your vegetables. So Dr. Tatis Karazian does too. So instead of using just four vegetables all the time for 2 weeks, we're gonna do a total of 20. I have 12 here, I have more in the fridge. We're gonna do a total of 20 vegetables and I'll put it in five different bags, right? And then I rotate it. So each day it's a little bit different and there's a variety. And then next time I go to the store, I might try something different. So this is the power of veggies and keto. Probiotic, prebiotic, bacteria, positive, good bacteria in your gut, health, vitality, better results, faster results, and staying keto at the same time, y'all. Talk to you soon.
Hey, thanks for watching the video. Just subscribe below if you want all the updates when we upload the newest videos on keto health, wellness, vitality. Check it out. Come join us.